Basically today this is going to be the first outfit, just nothing but a pair of Dickies, the double knees. I took the little patch off on the side here so you can still kind of see that. And then I have a pair of Daniel Lee Bottega crepe boots, or military calf boots, or whatever the real name of these are. Really solid and durable boot. Usually for Los Angeles, I tend to pack a little bit more on the lighter side, or just when I'm going on vacation in general, just because I don't really like taking too much stuff with me, and I just like to dress a little bit more like, I guess more on like the simpler side. So basically this is what the outfit's gonna look like. More luxe, more simpler. Not much going on, but I like to keep it that way, you know? The collection is amazing. Like, I'm literally so overwhelmed by like how everything is organized. Like, you're never gonna find another store like this.
I can recommend a tailor for you if you want to keep that. And
honestly, it sits over the boots really nicely.
Yeah. It's, well, a cool pant.
They are like really sick. And this is like size small.
That's a small size. That's an extra small.
Extra small.
Yeah. Got it.
What's up, guys? My name is Josh. We're here at Group B, Los Angeles. This is the showroom right here in downtown. A bunch of clothes. We have over 500 pieces, a lot of Chrome Hearts jewelry. So as you can see, we have over 50 pairs of pants.
Is it like consignment or is it just like personal pieces?
Sometimes we do consignment, but most of the time it's all purchased from us.
Purchase from you?
Yeah.
Oh.
This guy came from Japan. He lost his legs on the way here. So now he serves his purpose as a bust right here.
Is that for sale? Or
it is for sale, half off.
Half off.
A good selection of Chrome Hearts jeans right here. We have the new pair, which is the 40 patch flood. It has a good amount of patches. Yeah, so it's black and camo.
Wow, that's crazy.
What else we got here? We also have a good selection of vintage jeans. As you can see, this is like a 2000s pair with nice leather patches on them. These ones are my favorite Chrome Hearts jeans in the store.
Yeah.
My favorite brand is Helmut Lang, and I would say these are very similar to Helmut Lang jeans. Really nice whiskers on the back too. Such a nice wash. So this part is all crew necks and hoodies and some knits. Can't go wrong. The Raf Simons Poltergeist crew neck in the nice cream color.
I think Alex had this one. I don't know if he still has it, if he sold it.
Actually, one of them is Alex's.
Yeah, Alex sold us his.
Yeah.
Nice Raf Penelope. If you guys watch Alex's YouTube, picture up here. Shout out to you, bro. Yeah, we still got it for you, bro. We also have the gray version right here. Black and red version. Pick your poison. So we got this guy.
That's a grail.
Everyone's favorite hoodie. If you know someone named Justin, shout out to you, Justin. I think you should come here and
really
get it.
Really says Justin forever.
Cool, this is a one-of-one hooded biker jacket with the Goopy hit on the sleeve, the Mad Market undercover one on.
Dude, that's nice.
Yeah, this one's really cool. This guy just looks like it's a regular CDG shirt, but this was actually owned by Lil Uzi.
Really?
Yeah.
How'd that end up here?
His friend's friend sold it to us.
Just a lot of people involved.
Yeah. He actually wore it to the Grammys. I forgot what year. I think it was 2023 or 2022.
Is that for sale?
It is for sale.
How much?
I don't know, honestly. Like, I feel like before we were asking like 2,000, but I think we're asking like around like 700, so it's like up in the air. Mm-hmm. We just kind of want to keep it just for like the vibes.
But
like, Uzi's just chilling in here. You know?
So if someone throws an offer, it's just like, yeah.
Come correct. The best SA Sport pieces right here. The wash tag or carry label bomber. This one's really nice. Nice heavy wool right here with the leather sleeves and the ribbing. Fits really nice, fits really wide and oversized. Of course, we have those big parkas. We have every parka from the closer season. This one is the PCL. This is actually closer, guys, so this one back.
Dude, I didn't even see the Prada phone.
Prada phone.
Didn't they say this was the first touchscreen?
I think it was. As you can see here, it's really cool.
Trap phone,
definitely. And also, this is one of my favorite pieces in the store. This is the GQ magazine that we are featured in.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so what we did was we chose the top 50 menswear pieces of all time. Let me see if I can pull it up.
And this is all from your guys' collection?
We curated most of them, but we just like, you know, had an opinion on our favorite. So it's the 50 holy grails of modern menswear. See, this is our pair of the 85 undercovers. We have the reverse Oreo dunks. What else is my favorite? Of course, the SA jacket, which you see behind you. One of my favorite pieces of all time, the 1985 Jordan
1985,
1. Revolutionized the sneaker game. For
you guys have any?
We don't here. I wish we did.
Yeah.
What else do we have? Of course, can't go wrong with the Rolex.
Dude, I remember that.
Can't go wrong with the 7-layer. What else? The Splogo.
Shit.
Red Octobers. Bus is here. No words are needed, but of course, they're chromed out. Really nice condition. See the daggers on the back, daggers on the side, cross on the front. Really cool. I think they're like a 101, or like it has to be a sample, because I've never seen it before.
I'm assuming that's been resold at the bottom.
Really old. Definitely old.
I'm surprised they're still sitting here.
Right? So all the cashmere made by Chrome Hearts is made by Elder Statesman.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a collab with them, but they made a cashmere octopus.
Wow, dude.
With the rhodium hardware eyes.
That's really soft.
Really nice. So if you need a little home accessory, and you want a chrome one,
yeah.
Get this little guy. This one's funny.
Just in case you need a shovel. You need to shovel something.
The Chrome Heart Shovel.
The Chrome Heart Shovel.
I've seen these. I'm surprised they don't use the hardware on this.
I think this is just a regular shovel, and then this is
they just made it a holder. Fit for that.
Yeah, they got lazy.
They got lazy with it.
This guy?
Yeah, that guy right there.
It's one of the best pieces in the drawer.
Fucking insane piece right here. Don't they have like the smoking pipe for this too?
Yeah, we used to have that.
You used to have it?
Mm-hmm. That one was fun.
Someone bought it?
Yeah.
Damn, it's wild.
So we gotta get the pen now. You guys, if you guys wanna come, you guys can make an appointment.
Yeah.
Or hit me up through my DM. And yeah.
Yeah, man. Shout out to
Josh. Josh likes clothes.
Josh likes clothes. Check out his YouTube as well. TikTok as well, I think.
TikTok as well. Josh
yeah, man.
Clothes.
This is insane right here in
Los Angeles. Well, where exactly, like, are we at in Los Angeles?
We are in Westlake, Los Angeles.
Westlake, Los Angeles. Yeah. Well, crazy. So next up on the list, I'm taking you guys to this super like underground location. Not very many people know about it. It's very like gatekept and shit like that. It's called Dover Street Market. It's a very fancy place. There's like a 5% chance of being able to meet Kanye and playing your mixtape for him. But yeah, let's go inside and I'll show you guys what's up. Now I'm gonna head out to the hidden showroom. We're gonna meet up with Kay, Tony, and Alex, and I'm gonna show you guys what they have in stock.
Respect the hats.
Like,
I see one, two, three, four.
He like makes a super compilation of every time he talks.
Damn, that needs to be framed on the fucking.
We'll put it right here above the clock.
Yo, we need to get that framed
above
the.
Right above the clock.
Oh my god, Loki, that'd be funny as fuck, man.
I've never listened to Blackpink in my life, right? But my buddy from the Bay, Jack, God bless his soul, who's in town. He's like, I want to go to the Blackpink concert. So we mobbed out to Vegas to go to the Blackpink concert. I guess I'm a blink now.
Yeah.
Hold on. There's a secret trick to change the color. Oh. I noticed. Hold up. Yeah.
Damn, dude.
I know for some of them, like when you're at the venue or whatever, when they have the concert, the light sticks sync up with like something that they have going in the stadium so that all the lights flash and like in sync. It's crazy.
People know Capital Borough Jacket. This is the godfather of the Capital Borough Jacket. Prot was the head product designer at Capital for over 10 years before he split off and made his brand. Proletariat Art. They play on the words proletariat, working class. Beautiful name because all he does is take working class, old vintage denim, old clothes, and repurposes it with his antique fabric. So these are all antique, old school US bandanas on old Levi's faces, completely deconstructed, reconstructed. I've been a big fan of Prot since his inception. I hate to be one of those, oh yeah, I heard of him first, but then this is actually one of his very first Borough rework sets. It's not numbered,
There's like barely any prop branding. It's just one of his OG sets before he started doing a lot of the bespoke stuff for artists like The Baby, Blase Blase, right?
Since he was a small account, he would actually individually message people that followed him, be like, hey, this is, I'm prop, this is what I do. And I just really loved his story, his narrative. And bro would really gas himself up in the most amazing way. He'd take he had a picture of his plaque at Capitol that said like who he was, his name and everything. I was like, oh, this guy's legit. I'm like, let me invest. So I got hit this with this type 3 trucker. Look at the detailing.
What are you guys doing over there?
Prop, man. Pro let every yard.
Prop.
The best.
You're talking about the overalls, too.
Come on, man. We can't not talk about the overalls.
Damn.
Hey, people want to talk K-pop, man. I was listening to K-pop in a time where I had to like hide that I was listening to K-pop back in like late middle school, early high school, man. Fucking listening to Big Bang and shit, bro. But this is one of one custom made for one of South Korea's most iconic pop stars, Taeyang. So the lining he had it made with custom, these are Hermes scarves with the Tutankhamun Egyptian pharaoh print. And you look at the tag right here, this has a size instead of size as his name. All the fixings, you got the little hammer pocket. 0.925 sterling silver hardware, daggers, plus buttons, wallet chain, little hooks right here too. Like, hey, only here at Hidden. I get this question a lot too. People are like, yo, what's your favorite thing in the store? I'll be honest, my favorite, the one thing in the store that makes me so happy, is this little wall clock. This little wall clock, bro, it's so sick. Look, that little red dot, that's the seconds hand. I think it's inspired by this Grand Seiko watch. It looks very similar with similar movement, but I found this on IG when I was looking for wall clocks when we were opening up the shop, and there it is in all of its glory.
How much was that?
It's like, I think it was like $80.
In a room full of damn near over 100K.
Some slight. This is a PS5 collaboration with Balenciaga.
Oh, classic right there.
Yeah, this is fun. Please don't cancel me. We also carry tons of Chrome Hearts. These are all brand new Chrome Hearts hoodies. Pants. Similar brand, similar vibes. A few more archive labels in here. Got some avant-garde. There's a nice little CDG Skort. My favorite number. 9. Get old Margiela. I like lines. CDG. Oh, dude, let's get this bread.
Oh,
got some.
Oh,
got some velvet. Let's get this bread.
The best pair of pants in here.
Yeah, these are fun. Yasuyuki Ishii. Fun. Oh, and I think these are slept on, but a nice homage to the new season, new seasons of Kenzo. This is Migo.
Oh, really?
You can tell by a little flower button here. Migos work here at Kenzo. Shirts, thermals. This is a staff thermal from 1989. I could tell it's from that year because, well, it says it.
Yep.
Yep. It's nice. We had a black one, but now we only have the white one. You're the Bay Area people into tech. Hold up. Shh. Come on, man. What you know about the Amazon Ambush collaboration? Come on, look at this, bro. With the tape on the back?
Bro.
Come on, man.
Don't play with it, man.
I'll be careful not to show anything that might get you demonetized.
That Amazon one might.
And then we gotta carry some of our memes out here. You know what it is. And you can't forget the Jared, bro. You gotta show some love to the Jared. How many Borrow jackets we have in this room right now? That's insane.
I think we all got it.
Brought mine with me.
We all put the prod on.
Can I see yours real quick?
Yeah, go ahead.
Mine has a red stain on the back. I don't know if it's normal on all of them.
That keeps me up at night.
Damn, bro. That's very Vietnamese archive of you.
Vietnamese archive.
You know, I feel like the Vietnamese archive heads are keeping me
sitting out. Dude.
Dude, I don't even exist.
It's my sleep paralysis demon. It's quite literally like... Say, what the fuck?
I'm dead.
Oh my god.
Such a good photo.
Is it filming out?
No.
Yeah?
No.
Any other type of shopping vlog video, you always have to end the video doing like a pickups haul type deal, because why would you not? So one of the first things that I want to show you guys, this is a CDG shirt jacket. This has been one of my grails for damn near half a year. No, a year and a half actually. The reason why it took me so long to find this is because, well, I honestly don't know the name of it. It's kind of a problem when it's called CDG shirt and then you try to Google CDG shirt and the only thing that comes up is the little heart thing that comes up with the Converse and stuff. So trying to look up CDG shirt jacket doesn't yield any good results. So you can probably see why it took me a long time to find this, but yes, very good, perfect fitting jacket. Tons of people have been asking me what it is, where did I find it, a little bit with the hem and tape, but it's kind of like undoing itself, so I need to get someone to like sew it.
You need like a professional.
Yeah, like a professional. Yeah. Most kind of jackets that are like this don't really have like a dual zipper, so you can kind of like zip this all the way up, kind of get this hanging out in the shoulder, not the shoulders, the armpits have the little ventilation, and then just a nice military green color really helps with the wardrobe with the more like muted color. They're on Instagram, it's called Humane Blanks. They kind of do a I would say like a better version of the Yeezy Gap hoodie that came out like year ish ago at this point. They do a wide variety of colors and stuff. They have the little lock on the side, so you can kind of like cinch it.
Oh wow.
Do stuff like that, or if you want to low bag it, you can also do that as well. Oh. The Yeezy Gap hoodies aren't gonna do that, so that's why these are a little bit better in my opinion. Oh yeah, the hat, another good pickup of mine, courtesy of our good friend Mai.
Mai Doe, relative of Peter Doe, who just opened for Helmut Lang in spring summer New York Fashion Week. So, very proud of her and very proud of him.
Did you watch the live stream?
Yes, of course I did.
Okay, I wasn't able to watch that.
Yeah, it's sad. It's actually very beautiful.
Yeah, this is Kiko. Nice little thing right there. The K. A lot of people think this means K-pop. It does not mean K-pop. It's just a simple new era Kiko hat.
How much did you get that for, actually, before we move on?
This was...
My priced? Oh, then that means it's a good deal.
Good deal. 100 bucks. Which, I've only found one selling for like 200. So. Did you know that Kiko was actually in San Francisco not too long ago?
Like... He himself or the brand?
No, like himself. He was actually in.
Did you say hi to him?
Okay, so the thing about it is he went to the antique fair, which is actually where I got these pants, but I'll get into that. He came to the antique fair on the one day I decided not to go. And I fucked up. Everyone was taking photos with him and posting pictures and things like that, so... Hey, win some, you lose some, am I right? It's hard for me to find jeans that kind of like fit in the proper good way. I know they kind of look like shit, but these are the Levi's Flared 684s, I believe is what they were. These have like a very, very good flare at the very bottom of it, of course. The back end has been like chewed off, like severely chewed off. Yeah, so very good.
Gorge,
pair
gorge.
Of nicely faded Levi's. I've been getting more into boots recently because I feel like they fit better in a more stable wardrobe, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. So these are going to be most of them, not all of them, but most of them. So these are called the Guidi something 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 back zip. Honestly, don't know, because Guidi has so many different variations and different boots and different leather and all that stuff. So it's just a newer version with the square toe. I really like the square toe look of it. So this was purchased off my good friend Kay. Shout out to Kay. Gave it to me for a very respectful price, so thank you for that. I needed something for everyday type deal, just easy, like slip on, grocery getting. This is the Bottega Puddle Slide, like $200 after tax, which is not bad for a little Bottega type deal. And I've been really liking their designs and everything recently, so a lot of their stuff is more sleek and more simple. Speaking of sleek and simple, Bottega, Daniel Lee, they are much more bigger. They have like the iconic mid layer. They do a lot in their designs, with this, of course, being like the crepe military calf boot, something, something like that.
How often do you wear them?
As you can tell, very often, because I wore these all over LA and they're cooked as shit. As you can see, there's a leaf embedded at the very these boots been getting a lot of love. They hold up very good. The leather quality is amazing on them. Anyways, these are the Balenciaga Pinocchio Clog Stomper 3000. What was it called again?
The space shoes.
It is a one piece. No, it is. I can't even like bend my foot.
It's just so unreal, and it's so pretty. Like, it looks like, it literally looks like a fin.
Uniqueness aspect is there.
Uniqueness is like 10.
10 out of 10. But is this something that I can wear practically?
Function is about 5.
Over function. Except I don't know if this falls under either category, but still. Cool design. But yeah, let's
but those are gorgeous.
Anyways, so yeah, that's gonna do it for the video. Hope everyone enjoyed that little pickups haul.
This is Branciaga before he was Branciaga. Who's that? That's crazy.
Hey, you had a bowl cut, bro? No, Korean, bro. Korean bowl.
Yeah. K-pop. Hey, Vince. Who's this?
No shot.
That's the Brandon I remember. That's the